Hey viewers, welcome back to a new Ramblin' episode with your boy Gildem, here talking about pretty much anything that I could think of, as well as, you know, gameplay footage, but that's not important, because, you know, I'm here just trying to ventilate thoughts, but, you know, you can watch what's going on, because, you know, it's probably riveting. Yeah, as far as I know, it's Pikmin, but again, I'm not focusing on Pikmin, I'm focusing on whatever I want to focus on, which is, you know, pretty much anything else that I can think of. And, if I sound a little weird, it's probably because I'm getting over a cold. You know, I had an ailment, I had the sickness, it was not fun. I had laryngitis for part of it, so I couldn't really talk. That was fantastic, but you know I'm obviously better, or at least I would think so, mainly because you know I'm here recording this, which is great because you know I want to do stuff for the YouTubes, and so it's like here I am. I wanted to do it last week because you know something happened to me, and it's like it was something I wanted to talk about. That's the hell I'm going to talk about it, but you know I'll get to that in a second, cuz you know I have to talk about me being sick, cuz you know that's something that happened, and apparently I wasn't the only one, cuz you know it's flu season and everyone's getting sick, and that kind of impressed me, cuz you know here I am thinking I'm the only one, but nope, everyone else, half my entire work area, or half my where I work, half the people apparently were sick, and a lot of them called in one day, including myself. So, yeah, everyone's kind of dealing with ailments. But you know, I guess that's not important. The important thing is I'm better. Maybe not 100%, but you know, I'm getting there. I'm working on it. What I am here to talk about, though, is before I got sick, I met up with a friend, and I have a really cool friend. He's one of my childhood chums that I've known for, like, ever. And when I say forever, I mean, like, I've known this kid since, like, first grade. And, I don't know if he was exactly my best friend back then, but, you know, it's like, I'm pretty sure, like, second grade, we were bros. Now that I think about it, I don't remember how that came to be, but it's just, like, It is what it is, and we were like, you know, we were like best friends. We hung out like all the time, and you know, he was like the guy that I went to in high school, and I think a lot of that had to do with the fact that, you know, he's very extroverted in the right places, that where it complements my introvertsies. Cause you know, it's like me being the guy that I am, I'm a pretty introverted individual. I don't know what else to say other than, you know, it's like, that's just my personality type for the most part. Granted, I think I brought that up, and then, you know, it's like, some days you feel more extrovert, while other days, you know, you're more introverted, and if I remember correctly, I also said that, you know, I tend to be more introverted than extroverted, and usually it kind of varies, but I guess that's not important. That's not why you're here. That's not what you're here to, like, listen to. You're here to listen to me kind of talk about, something else than what I've already said. Or at least, that is my goal. I don't know. I guess it doesn't really matter on your end, because, you know, again, rambling part, so I can pretty much just talk about whatever. But, you know, I want to make progress. I mean, I could revisit old subjects, but, you know, not the point. So, you know, moving on, because I gotta move on. Anyways, so yes, moving on. I got a friend, met up with him last week. It was great, because for the longest time, I could not meet up with my friend. He has, like, the exact opposite schedule that I have. See, I work nights, and he's pretty much, like, he works mornings. And, I don't know, it's like, it's really hard for me and him, because, he's going to bed when I'm pretty much waking up, and, it's kind of vice versa in a lot of ways. You know, I'm going to bed when he's waking up. So, it doesn't really work out too well trying to hang out with my friend. So, like, there was, like, this period where, like, we just weren't able to hang out. I think the only way we were really, like, keeping in contact was just pretty much, like, text message or, like, Facebook. So, you know, it was kind of depressing, you know? It got to the point where I actually had to be like, bro, we gotta do something, man. We gotta like, rectify this, because I missed you. And, you know, he's very compliant, so we tried to make it work. And God bless his soul, you know? It's difficult from his perspective, or at least I think it would be. Mainly because he's got family that he's got to deal with. He's got like 3 kids, a wife. Yeah, I don't know what else to say other than that. 3 kids, a wife. I think some pets. I think, but you know that irrelevant, not important. I'm moving on. Responsibility. Yes, there we go. He's got responsibility that he's got to deal with, and so doesn't always work out that, you know, we can hang out and chill and do all the stuff that you normally do with your friends and your bros. And to make matters more difficult, I guess, for the most part, you know, I'm a bachelor with like no responsibility, so the exact opposite of my friend. But again, you know, we compliment each other in the right ways, so it's like, so that's why I think our personality types, like, actually work out pretty well. I mean, even to today, you know, it's just like, it's kind of one of those weird situations where it's like, huh, that's cool. And I'm fine with it, you know.
Excuse me.
A little tired. Anyways, so what was I saying? I met up with him, because here's the thing. Even though we weren't really able to, we figured out that apparently there's this period in the day that's, like, actually the golden opportunity. That's basically, early in the morning when he's, like, waking up and, I'm getting off work. Apparently, it's like the perfect time to go to like one of those 24-hour diners and just grab a bite to eat. And we figured this out, and it worked out very well. So yeah, we just made that happen, and it's great. For a couple months, we were actually making it work, and I was happy. He was happy. We were just chilling and grabbing a bite to eat, and yeah, it's good. It's good for the both of us. We're able to talk about things and current events and, you know, all that stuff. Although, I must say, it does make me feel super old, because, I don't know about you, but, you know, I feel like this is something senior citizens, that's what they do, you know? It's like, you have a bunch of old people meeting up their friends, going to one of those 24-hour diners early in the morning, getting, some food, or what have you, so... You know, I admit that's like probably the only thing that makes me feel like super old about this. But, you know, I don't care. Point is, you know, I get to meet up with my friend, hang out with them, and talk about life. And it's just like high school all over again. Except I feel like the topics are a lot more mature, so to speak. Like, you know, insurance and... like medical issues, because when you get older, you have like aches and pains and stuff like that. Not that, you know, I have anything like arthritis, but you know, it's like, you know, my job, what I work and what I do, you know, it's a little strenuous. I can't lie, but you know, I don't think you really want to hear about that. What I'm saying is, you know, my friend, I'm able to hang out with him, and that makes me feel great. It makes me happy, even though, you know, I still haven't seen his family in a while, and I should, because I like his family. It's a little overwhelming, and I think a lot of that has to do with me being an introvert, and you know, being social, at least from my perspective, it can be a very strenuous and exhausting sort of situation, especially when he has like 3 kids and a wife. because I had to, like, divide up my, I have to, like, kind of multitask that and balance it, and it's, like, it does not work well when you can't, like, multitask. And also, you know, being an introvert, my social skills aren't exactly the best, but, you know, I still do it, because I like him. He has pretty cool kids. They're very chill, and I like that, because kids stress me out. I don't know. I don't even know. Like, I found out recently, apparently there was a point where I've become kind of anti-kid, and I don't know why, because I like kids, but at the same time, they make me super nervous. I don't know. I live next to the school, and it's like, I always feel like, kids, they do something, and it's like completely unexplained, and you're like, how do I deal with this? For the longest period, there was like this kid that was like practicing his, it was one of those brass instruments. He was practicing that right outside like my window area, and I kept waking me up. It was not good. And I was like furious because, you know, I get grumpy when I wake up. It's not a good situation. So, you know, it's like, I guess maybe like various things like that kind of made me anti-kid. Because, you know, the guys, like, I don't know. I just don't like dealing with kids sometimes. I don't even know how to deal with kids. I think that might also contribute to the fact that kids make me nervous. Because it's like, say I had a kid. I wouldn't know how to deal with, like, punishment and stuff like that. You know, trying to be a responsible parent. I feel like it's kind of hit and miss sometimes. I feel like it could probably be like the caring, like, approachable parent, but at the same time, it's like, if I had to deal with punishment, I'm not even sure how to deal with that. It makes me kind of stressed out thinking about it. In fact, I'm feeling stressed out now that, you know, I brought it up. So I'm gonna avoid talking about that, because, you know, it's not important. It's completely irrelevant. I don't have to deal with that. I can be a bachelor, and, you know, I find some liberty and some solace. Yeah, solace is a good word. I find some solace in that. So I'm going to deal with solace. And I have a new understanding for, like, anybody who says I never want kids. Because I think it's perfectly fine not having kids. Because, you know, you don't have the responsibility of having to deal with kids. And, you know, that's one thing that stresses me out a lot. If it wasn't made clear, I was getting stressed out a second ago talking about it. But, you know, completely irrelevant. Not going to readdress the issue. Just going to move on and talk about my pal, my buddy. Because I wasn't done. You know, so we meet up, talk about life, talk about things. And it's good. But recently, last week, he's talking about moving, like, out of state. And when I say out of state, I mean, like, I live on the West Coast. He's talking about moving to the East Coast. And so it's, or, like, closer to the East Coast. No, the East Coast. North Carolina. I live in Washington State. So, yeah, it's, like, that's quite the distance, you know? It's, like, I'm not gonna be able to hang out with my friend, on a monthly basis now. It's gonna be just like how it was, you know? Text message and stuff like that. Granted, he's still got a visit up here in Washington State, so it's not like I'll never get to see him again. I mean, even if that was the case, I'd at least try to, like, fly down at like some odd times just to, like, hang out with him, because I care about the guy that much. So it's not like I will never see the guy again. It's just it's just kind of one of those situations where it's like, man, I feel like we'll never see each other again. And I mean, like, I think a lot of it is initially that's how it feels. But at the same time, I don't really know what else to say other than it's like, I do kind of understand him, and I am kind of proud of him because, you know, Washington State, it's expensive. It's like, I don't know. Growing up, you find that life is expensive. Everything is expensive. But, you know, I think also that's a part of responsibility and growing up, you know, managing bills and whatnot. And I do manage bills, because, you know, I try to be responsible. Or at least, I like to think I try to be. Regardless, yeah, I'm proud of my friend. I'm glad that he's actually getting out and, like, trying to find somewhere else where, you know, he can thrive a lot better. Because, you know, he really puts a lot of effort into what he does, and he really tries hard, and, you know, it's just one of those things where it's like, I'm glad he's actually trying to do something about his situation, because he's never had it easy, and, I don't even know if I should really be talking about this in, like, super detail, but it's like, he really puts up with a lot, but at the same time, you know, I gotta be honest, I don't think I could do it. With the amount of stress and responsibility that he has to deal with, I don't think I could do it. Granted, I feel like he kind of adjusted to it, but at the same time, I don't think anyone could do it. But he's managed to deal with it. And, you know, the fact that he's actually going through with this, you know, I'm really proud of him. I'm really glad that he's actually trying to find better ways to make his life easier, because, you know, he deserves it. So, I don't know what else to say other than, you know, I really wish him a lot of luck. It's not for certain. That is the one thing he was just bringing up, because his company is actually sending him over some sort of job thing, you know. So, it's not that he's transferring over there yet. It's that he's on a business trip. And, while he's there, he's just gonna check out the situation and see, some things before he makes the move. But, at the same time, he sounded very admirable about it, so we'll see. I may revisit this issue. I don't know. But, you know, it's like, again, proud of him. I'm glad he's actually trying to do something about his current situation, and I don't know. I told him, like, if it sounds really good, who knows? Maybe I'll join him, because yeah, Washington State, it's expensive. Oddly enough, I have a lot of friends on the East Coast. I have family on the East Coast. I was born on the East Coast, so, you know, maybe I belong on the East Coast. Who can say? I digress. I live on the West Coast, like, and I mean, like, it's not bad. I like it up here. It rains. I like the rain. I don't know if that's depressing or anything. I don't know. I think the rain's exciting, though. I think storms are exciting. I'm sure I'm not the only one who can say that, but, I mean, what else can I say other than, you know, I like rain. It's life-giving. Come on, it makes plants grow. Everyone likes plants. Or at least, I would hope so. Mother Earth. Because, you know, it's like, I like to think I have somewhat of a green thumb. I know I have, what is it, like, great-great-grandparents that were, like, farmers? They were, like, farmers in Kansas or something like that. And then, something happened, so they moved up here. It might have been the Dust Bowl. I'm not even sure. Point is, I know I have, like, family that were farmers. And, you know, it's like, I enjoy farming. And if I ever had the chance, I would totally be a farmer. I just don't have the opportunity or, like, you know, the finances to do that. But, I don't know. Maybe if I found someone who was interested in that, I would totally get into agriculture. Cause I think it could be fun. I like seeing stuff grow. You know, it's kind of like, it's kind of rewarding in a sense. Just cause, you know, it's like you're helping something actually thrive. It's just kind of awesome. I don't know. I feel like I need to plant something now. Cause I don't know. But, like, the one thing I've always kind of, like, had in mind whenever I grow something, really. Because, like, I do grow plants. I like plants. I'll grow them. I've grown them. I had tomatoes once, and that was awesome. Except I don't like tomatoes, but growing tomato plants are kind of cool. But I like growing stuff that you can eat, or at least like has some sort of product that's edible. Cause I don't know. I kind of think it's fun having something that you grow and then you can eat. Not so much in the sense that, you know, you're growing your food, but kind of in the sense that, you know, it's a reward for, like, your hard work, your hard effort. And, I like food. I can't lie. Food is amazing. I think this is why I'm such a big guy, but, you know, it's like, I have nothing against growing your food. I think growing your food is kind of awesome. So, you know, I like growing plants that are very edible, or at least have some sort of like byproduct that is edible. You know, fruit is amazing, and I like fruit. Fruit is very sweet, and as someone who likes sweets, you know, I have nothing against fruit, or rather, I should say fruit is amazing. Vegetables are equally just as good, but at the same time, like, they're not as sweet, or at least they tend not to be. Now that I think about it, carrot is a vegetable, right? It should be. God, now I sound so stupid, because, you know, it's like, Gildem, you're so illiterate. What are you talking about? You're just like, carrot is a vegetable? Well, I mean, it is, right? I don't know. I'm not going to put an edit or anything. Someone can correct me on that. Point is, I like carrots. Carrots are sweet. They're delicious. At the same time, they have benefits, but at the same time, I heard that they're not as healthy as you think they are. I mean, like, I think the best stuff that you can eat is, like, you know, dark leafy greens, or at least that's why I choose to believe, like, dark leafy greens are, like, better for you, but, I could be completely wrong. I don't know. I feel like I need to, like, check my nutrition facts. Probably a good idea. I know someone probably will correct me. Someone who's, like, who's really in tune with, like, nutrition and diets and stuff like that. If they happen to be watching. For all I know, probably this is getting viewed by a few people. Maybe, like, me. And, like, someone else. Who just, like, happened to wander by and be like, huh, what is this? But, you know, that irrelevant. Point is, just rambling on about, you know, growing stuff. And I like growing stuff. I don't care what anyone says. Farming is amazing. Agriculture is pretty awesome. And again, I would totally be a farmer if I ever got the opportunity. I would also do other things, like, I don't know. Working in like some sort of animal. Sorry, having pronunciation issues. I think a lot of it has to do with the fact that, you know, I'm still slightly sick. But irrelevant. Point is, I like animals, and working with animals is pretty cool. I used to volunteer. I'm not currently, and I'm thinking about it, but at the same time, like, I'm thinking about going back and volunteering, because there's a lot of rewarding. There's a lot of things that make me nervous. I don't know if it's because I'm an introvert, because, like, I feel like part of, like, actually being at a place long enough is that you kind of get this underlying responsibility where, you know, people assume you know stuff, even though, like, that's not really true at all. Being the introvert that I am, I have trouble trying to take up leadership roles. Because it's just not for me. I don't like leadership positions. And I don't like that kind of stress. I don't like being in charge. I like helping people in charge, but, you know, it's like, that's about the extent that I will go to in being in charge. That, or relying on strict experience. And I think that's a lot of the reason why, if you're at a place long enough, people look up to you, because, you know, supposedly you have that experience. Although, you know, it can be deceptive. You can be at a place long enough and not really have the experience one bit. Because, you know, sometimes you just drift on and you're just like, whatever. I'm just chilling. Then again, like, other places, I don't know. You're just kind of chilling and it's not really that hard. It's not rocket science. Like, my job. You know, it's not rocket science. It's pretty straightforward. Regardless, I was volunteering at a place and I was there for a couple years and, you know, I worked with the animals and it was pretty cool. I got to do a lot of really sweet things, like I got to hold some raptors. And if anyone doesn't is kind of a little clueless what I say about raptors, I'm talking about birds of prey. You know, you got falcons and you got owls and you got hawks and you got eagles. I never dealt with like any bald eagles, but got them in where I volunteered, and I actually got to see an eagle up close, and it was pretty awesome. They have extremely large talons, but something I did get to do was I got to hold some a couple owls and I think a red-tailed hawk. Actually, I think a couple red-tailed hawks. Point is, like, I got to deal with some of the birds of prey, and that was pretty awesome. So it's like I have a little bit of experience when it comes to animals. That's better. Had to get a drink. Anyways, point is, I like animals. I like dealing with animals, but you know, it's also it can be difficult at times, especially where I was working, because I was dealing with wildlife. So it's not like you always get to have more of a handling or a personal one-on-one sort of situation with wildlife, because, you know, when you're dealing with wildlife, like, the thing is, you're not actually trying to, like, you know, get them accustomed to, like, humans. In fact, you want them to be very afraid of humans, because, you know, you're just rehabilitating them so you can put them back into the wild. And that's generally the idea behind rehabilitation. Especially with wildlife, it's like you're just there to get them better so that they can be reintroduced to their natural habitat. Because, you know, that's where they belong, that's where they're meant to be. So, you know, like, oftentimes when you're dealing with a wild animal, you know, you gotta have this level of caution, you gotta be careful. Especially with the birds of prey, with their talons, because they're sharp. And you will get hurt if you're not prepared for that. But they do give you extensive education on how to handle raptors and any sort of other, like, animals that you encounter. Like, for instance, I got to help baby squirrels, and that was awesome. Because, you know, they're pretty adorable, but at the same time, you're not trying to actually, you know, fall in love with your baby squirrel. You're trying to, you know, help it so it can get strong enough and old enough, because, you know, it's a baby squirrel, it can't actually, like, you know, survive in the wild as is, so, you know, you kind of have to, like, help imitate, like, the natural surroundings so that it'll get, like, old enough, and then it can be reintroduced, because squirrels are like that, and, you know, here in Washington, we have a lot of eastern grays, but, there's also, Douglas squirrels, and those are pretty cool. I find that chipmunks, though, they're pretty wily. They're pretty crazy. So I do not have a love for the chipmunks. I mean, they're cute. Don't get me wrong. Chipmunks, they're adorable. So it's like, I don't know what else to say other than you know, it's like I never really had much of a love for, like, dealing with chipmunks when I had to volunteer, because we'd get them in and you know, you kind of help them out a little bit, but at the same time, like, trying to get them out of the cage, they were, like, super just everywhere, and it was not fun. they were quite I don't know. It was annoying. Is that a good? That's a good word. It was really annoying just trying to deal with chipmunks. But anyways, I mean, like, I don't know what to say. At least, like, you know, I got to help out, and you know, it's a rewarding feeling. One of my favorite cases though that I got to work it at was like there was a bar owl, and it was dealing with the case of Asper. And I remember, like, the thing that they would say is Asper, it's a fungal infection. And with, birds, especially, like, the birds of prey, since they live at a higher altitude, basically, their immune systems aren't really used to a lot of the, natural fungal spores that, you know, are kind of more low to the ground. Like, for instance, like, us people, like, we breathe that stuff in all the time, you know, there's, like, fungal spores and stuff like that on the air, so you kind of breathe it in, but your immune systems, they're, like, naturally able to just, like, kind of tackle that and take care of it. But because, you know, you have, like, the birds that roost up in, like, you know, the trees at a higher altitude, like, they don't have to deal with that, so, you know, their immune systems aren't used to it. So, you know, when a bird, especially a bird of prey, but really any bird that like, is not used to it, if they contract it, it's, I wouldn't say it's a death sentence, but it's not looking good. Especially in the more advanced cases, because, you know, it usually leads to a bad situation. It's pretty grim. So, they take in the birds, like, and there was a bar owl, it had this fungal infection, it had Asper. I don't remember, I want to say it was, like, I don't even remember. I'm not the point. Point is, fungal infection thing, it was bad, and, but they were trying to, like, you know, they were giving it antifungal medication to try to combat it, and they were really hoping that it would work. And I got to help with that, you know, I got to help administer, like, some of that to the bar owl. I got to hold it, and I also got to give it fungal medication, and that was awesome. Because, you know, I actually had a hand in trying to help it. And it turns out that case actually turned out very successful. Because not only did, like, the treatment work, it actually actually was, like, successful. And it got better. And it got released. So now it's in the wild. And it was a good day for me, because, you know, I helped with it. And so it made me feel accomplished, because I got to help save a bar owl. And I was happy about that. So, yeah, that is one of my favorite cases, volunteering at the place that I got to volunteer with the wildlife. I don't know why I brought that up, but I think that's a good note to kind of end off on, because, you know, it's a happy story. I got to help save an owl. I got to help save an owl. And so, you know, I don't really know what else to say other than, you know, life is crazy. Life is random sometimes. But, you know, I guess my point is I like helping animals, cuz animals are good. So, anyways, I guess this is as good of a time to end off the part. So, you know, this has been a rambling episode. It's been, whatever. I don't really know what to say. I'm gonna end it off. Okay. You guys, you take it easy. You chill out. Do your thing. I'll talk to you later. See ya.